nervous, but to us, it never really looked like they were in any trouble.
No, but we're right to be nervous before the game, pessimistic, because, you know, the form's not been good. But there were so many positives to come out of today. I thought Nat Phillips and Cabat looked like a good combination. Defensively, they were sound. Favino back in midfield just makes them a much better team. So, yeah, great result.
Couple of good wins in the Premier League going into the next round, and life will look a lot more kind of satisfying for Liverpool fans, really.
Yeah, and that's what they'll be hoping, that this game will be a catalyst then to go on and produce a little bit of form. And we always talk about this stage of the season, momentum being key. They need to kind of produce that, and performances have to improve in the Premier League.
Yeah, there's a lot of season left.
Yeah, and we touched on it before the game. You can rule out certain teams in the Champions League, but you can't rule out... form is not there at the moment. That was a stepping stone tonight. But just as quickly as your form can go, it can come back again, and there's not many teams that you can say, yeah, definitely they're good enough to win it. Yeah. Liverpool are a good enough team to win the Champions League, no question.
Not with that defence, though, come on.
No, but, I mean, Rio time, it's another two or three. There's still a long time to go.
With that defence...
Matip might be back, and you never know what's going to happen. I agree. At this moment in time, Manchester City are a better team than Liverpool. Of course they are. But as quickly as it can go wrong, it can come back again.
Yeah, it can when you're fundamentally that good.
Exactly.
Yeah, they're a top-class side. Listen, you don't lose it as quickly as they have done. But I think tonight was a massive result, but they've got to build on it now.
If Van Dijk and Gomez ain't there, they don't win the Champions League for me at all. Mm. There's Bayern, there's Man City, there's PSG, we sort of gone through, I think, in the other game. So those teams will be licking their lips if they come up against a centre-back pairing like that, I'm afraid, at this level.
Yeah, beautifully put. Just in time for me to tell you about Paris Saint-Germain. Yes, they, as expected, they managed to hold on against Barcelona. Very much a holding on. OK, let's hear from one of Liverpool's goal-scoring heroes. The one player that's been consistently good all season, Mo Salah, is with Des Kelly.
Mo, congratulations. You're through to the last eight. That's a big result tonight with all that's been happening at Liverpool lately.
Yeah, it's a big result for us. You know, we came here with... We lost a couple of games, a few games in the Premier League, and you know the team is not in the best shape. But we want to fight in the Champions League, and we want to fight also in each game in the Premier League, and we see what will happen.
Fighting, right? That was a very controlled and positive performance this evening.
Yeah, it's a really positive. To be fair, it's a tough team. They play football. They make us run a lot today, and we try to play our way, to press high and, you know, get the ball and go counter-attack. I think we did well. We won the game. That's the most important thing. And, yeah, it's a positive thing to take from that game, and hopefully we can keep continuing with that in the Premier League as well.
Yeah, your goal in the 71st minute, that was vital, because there was a little bit of concern. You had a lot of chances and you kept missing them. So people started to get a little bit anxious, maybe.
Well, I score good numbers this season. Hopefully, I would love to score more, but it's a part of the game that you miss chances, and you know you want to score all the time. You want to help the team, but as much as the team keep winning, that's the most important thing. So I'm happy that I scored today the first goal and the team won. That's the most important thing.
And a word on the defence. They looked very comfortable this evening.
Yeah, I think it's hard. You know, we had a few players that get injured, and you know, we had a few injuries this season. We were unlucky, but the most important thing is we need to keep fighting. I know it's really hard, and everybody can see that. But as much as everybody tried to give 100% and keep fighting in the game, I think we just need to.
Peter just said he thought he was the cameraman. It was so high on the camera. It's quite amusing. It could be a game-changer for them, this little bit of, you know, a win, a victory through to the quarterfinals. Bit of positivity around the place.
Yeah, that's it, the positive energy that a win can give you, definitely. And he spoke about nervousness being creeping out onto the pitch. And hopefully that alleviates it a little bit, because you need a moment, you need a goal, especially as strikers. You guys know more than anyone that a goal can really change not only your fortunes, but also your mind state. And when you walk on that pitch, you're not goals, and hopefully that filters through the rest of the team.
I think confidence-wise, it's probably more important for Mane than Salah, wasn't it?
I think as a team, when you're going through a bad patch, you try to cling on to something to give you a positive spin on things. Champions League, a new competition, can often do that. Getting your strikers scoring is vitally important. You know, it's great. Everyone will say we'd like to spread it round, but the bottom line, the crux of the matter is they're the match winners and you need them confident more
than
anyone.
They're the most important players on the
pitch. Of course they are.
You might say that, yeah.
Well, you just spend your time stopping them, so they must be.
Yeah, without us as the foundations, you can't win anything.
OK, let's have a look at Liverpool's opening goal, which, well, clinched it, really, didn't it? That's all they needed was, you felt, was one goal.
It was a beautiful goal. It was lovely, flowing really move. Goal. I mean, it's just what we haven't seen. And Jota starts it. Makes a fabulous run. There was, you know, nice pass inside by Salah. He continues it as well. It's, you know, people get into the box and Mo Salah in his position. Yeah. It's the Liverpool of old. Yeah. It really was. It was a beautifully worked goal.
Salah building right from the back as well there.
It was, yeah, right the way through the pitch. Movement off the ball. Salah making that run out to win. He chops across as well. Upamecano should have really sent him down on his right foot, but he actually cuts inside him and he cuts inside his defender as well, so he can't bring him down. And then once you're on your left foot like that, goalkeepers naturally move him one way and you hit it in the other corner.
We raved about Upamecano last season, but we've seen him three or four times this season.
He's gone backwards.
Poor, and Bayern Munich have spent a lot of money on him.
Bayern Munich have bought him, but he's gone backwards for me. That goal there was woeful defending, letting him back inside and on his stronger foot.
Yeah.
He's going to have to improve once he gets to Bayern, I'm telling you.
Yep. Mane.
Yeah, well, obviously he needed his goal, didn't he? Yeah. I thought front three today were, you know, played very, very well. Yeah. I know it wasn't a great performance from Leipzig, but it was good for him to get his goal. And he didn't look like a man out of form the way he took it, because it was more difficult than it looked this. You know, once Origi loses it there, it's three quick, incisive passes.
Great football. That's the Liverpool we're used to seeing.
Brilliant. I mean, it really was. And then Divock Origi puts in a fabulous ball. And it was a harder finish than that looked. He made that look very, very easy.
How would you normally finish that? What would you? That would be the last one you would do with the outside of the foot coming across.
I think it's a standard, mate. For starters, Origi does great, and I think centre forwards are very good at crossing them because they know exactly what you want.
You know where you want.
And if he takes another touch and then crosses it, the opportunity's gone. So he lifts his head, he crosses it. To answer your question, Rio, I think it's an understated or underused term in terms of how you score a goal like that, because it's so easy to hit it over the bar. Yeah. And if you keep trying, and Gary will know as much as anyone, and Crouchy, if you just try to hit pure contacts all the time, half the time it will go up. He's actually killed the pace there. He's hit it on the bottom of the ball, but even though he's hit it in the bottom, you'd naturally think goes high. Because he's sort of stabbed it with backspin, it actually kills the pace of the ball and keeps it down.
In fact, it's almost, isn't it, Michael, in those circumstances, you see players occasionally hit it over the bar, and it's always when they hit through the ball.
Exactly.
What you do, it's almost like you're controlling it, isn't it? It's like when you take the weight off it, so it just almost stops it, so it can't go up, it can only go down. And he did
see you do that after. I'm going to get a ball and throw it at you and see how it works out.
That was his rage, that was hamstring.
I can't move these days. I think for Liverpool, it was really important to get Fabinho back, wasn't it?
Yeah.
In that midfield role particularly, I think.
Yeah, I think they've missed him, haven't they?
Oh,
yeah.
It's so comforting watching him, isn't it? When he's in the middle, you feel safe. And we got a few clips of what he did. And nothing spectacular today.
Yeah.
But just so comforting having him back in his rightful position, Crouch. I mean, some of these clips are brilliant. Just how you'd want a sitting midfielder that almost... Well, he covers the back two, which is a weak part in the team.
Yeah, it's just... It's not... You know, it's not... beautiful to watch at times, but he's just in the right positions at the right time. His touch is nice, you know, he controls the game. He's always calm in possession. I think he's done a very, very good job at centre-half, but the biggest miss is him out of midfield.
Do you think it was it's easy in hindsight, isn't it? Was it a mistake pulling him into the back four because you lose so much? I know they've lost a lot of central defenders, but do you think that was perhaps...
Yeah, well, this is the first time we've seen him since October in midfield.
Yeah.
And Liverpool look a much better side. I think him and Henderson in the midfield, you know, when Henderson gets back fit as well, that's going to make a real difference. And if those two can, you know, Kabak and Phillips can get a good partnership going in the Premier League and those two are back in midfield, then it's going to look...
He gives the defenders confidence because he stops the ball into the strikers. He stops the pathways, the lanes into the strikers just through standing in the lane so the ball can't get down there. So for a defender, they can drop off a little bit so the ball's not going to get in behind them because they know the ball can't come to feet. So if someone like that in front of you, the confidence that then spreads through other defenders and players in the team hasn't been there in the last few months because he's been in the back four.
I also think it's easy in hindsight to say just play him in his position. Mm. The problem with Liverpool, have got they're top heavy in midfield. They've got so many midfield players, and none of them were injured really. So all of a sudden, when you get a glut of injuries, it's very difficult to put inexperienced players.
Yeah.
When you've got then the likes of Thiago and Jordan Henderson or whoever else that would be sitting on the bench maybe if the likes of Ronaldo and Fabinho are playing. So it's easy in hindsight, but I think he had to probably put a bit of experience back there.
He was the only one in the midfielders you actually can play in the back four. He played at right back, especially for Monaco. Yeah. So he knows what to do
Henderson
when he gets back there.
Done it a bit.
But I mean, before they actually went there this season.
Nat Phillips, his Champions League debut. He wasn't even registered in the group stage. He did really well.
Yeah. For a Champions League debut, you just didn't put a foot wrong. I know Rio's saying that Liverpool can't win a Champions League with those two centre-halves.
I think he's talking about the bandana more than anything.
the Terry Butcher. but listen, it's his first game in the Champions League. He didn't put a foot wrong. I understand exactly where Rio's coming from. They've lost Matip, Gomez, Van Dijk, who are the three first-choice centre-backs. But tonight, he didn't put a foot wrong. I thought he headed it when he needed to head it. I thought his positional sense was very good. And he cleared some dangerous-looking passes and crosses.
If you're wearing a do-rag on your debut in the Champions League...
What?
You're doing well. But no, listen, I thought he didn't put a foot wrong. Like Raji said, you put in there, the pressure's on. You've got to understand the spotlight is on any centre-back that comes in this team now. That's big pressure. So to go in there and do that, after being an unregistered player, as you said, you have to take that to him.
Yeah, he's done really well. As for Leipzig and... bit of a blow to Nagelsmann, isn't he? He's much talked about, sought after probably after this. A lot of big clubs will be looking at him. Does that kind of diminish his reputation slightly?
I think so. When you take into consideration the form that Liverpool have been in over the last month or so, Liverpool have breezed through the two legs, 4-0 on aggregate. It poses a question about German football and the strength of it at the moment.
They've got the Champions League winners.
Well, they have, but... Yeah. Yeah, I still don't think Bayern Munich. I don't think Bayern Munich were the best team in Europe last year. I don't, personally. No. But
do you
they were the champions. No, I mean,
they won everything.